was beautiful. Yes, and as a matter of fact, we spent yesterday afternoon and evening trying to find a place where the sun was shining that we could take the club. We tried Yucatan, Puerto Rico. We even tried the Astrodome in Houston. No. They're getting ready for the rodeo in Houston, so we couldn't get in there. And the real trouble was we couldn't get a plane and crews on such short notice. Even Bob Pecunio from United, who was as usual most cooperative in Chicago, couldn't pry loose a plane to take our 40 members somewhere. And got a hold of Frank Mankiewicz to see if he could get a hold of Mr. Castro to go to Havana. We didn't get any chance to talk to Mr. Castro. He didn't call back. But we were desperate. Today is better. It stopped raining, and the sun is trying to get through, and we're getting what is a limited workout. But one of the things that is most fascinating to me in spring training, the last 2 years have been Larry Doby working with young hitters. He has infinite patience, and he is, I think, probably the best instructor. And you can see the hitters improve. A youngster by the name of Thad Bosley, who has a tremendous future, changes the style of swing. So we talked to Larry about it. He says he's one of the quickest learners that he's ever had.
All right, there you are. There you go. Those hands up, that'll work. All right. All right, you tell me how you feel.
Terrible. I know I swung bad, too.
Swung bad. Huh? You swung bad a few times. You thinking a lot?
Yeah.
Don't start thinking. Let's kind of get a fix in our minds of one thing, or maybe no more than two now when we go back in there again. In other words, let's have the hands up and think about bringing them down, period. It wasn't all that bad. Don't be too critical now. I know. You want to be as good as you possibly can, or better. Fine, I want you to be that way. But don't press yourself in a situation where mentally now you start going back.
I know, okay, I see you.
All right? See, the more we press it, the less we're going to get the results we're going to get. In other words, we're not going to have no fun if we press it. We want to have some fun. I could tell every time you swung at a baseball and didn't hit it like you wanted to, you got a little bit more eager. You got a little bit more anxiety involved. Don't have that much anxiety involved. Anxiety builds up tension. You don't want that.
And I didn't have composure with myself.
No.
To where
no.
I was moving into the
ball. It'll be better next time. It'll be better.
Well, I feel real good because it seemed like someone's going to give me a chance to play. I mean, I've been playing 11 years and I've never really had a chance to play. I think it's something like 59 guys coming to camp and there's only 24 or 25 jobs. And the more work they get in, the better chance they have to make the club.
So what do you think? How are you doing?
Well, you can't really tell how you're doing now. Just been running and hitting the cage, but I feel okay. I feel pretty good.
Slider. Slider. Does Hinton have a chance to make it here this year?
Yes, he could. He's an intelligent guy. 2 years ago, the year before, he was brought up by the Cincinnati club. He did not fare well when they brought him up. Now he may be better than he's ever been in his career. And left-handers are scarce. So now it might be that Hinton won't make conceivably not open with the club. but he's in the wings for that left hander. You might need it.
You talk about marginal players and stuff. Well, maybe I'm a marginal player, but I'm a marginal player on the high end. I'm always the last guy to get cut. I'm always, it's always this thing. I'm just always right knocking on the door. So for as far as I'm concerned, as far as playing baseball, I'd rather get down in the dirt and rub around a little bit and things. And you look, everything's really, that's what the word is, sterile. That's what it is. It's a sterile type of game. You walk out in the field, it's just perfectly manicured. There's no dust and there's no dirt. And for a little kid that grows up and playing, and any kid that grows up, he's going to be out scrapping in the dirt and the dust and sweating, and that's where the baseball is to me. That's what I enjoy about it. You get hot and you're out there working. You can do the same thing in the big leagues, but you've got to look past that.
Spring training, you know, I'm not going to say. It's the true harbinger of spring, or any of these, you know, well-worn phrases. What I'm really going to say is that these anthropologists and religionists who say that the Garden of Eden is some piece of sandy real estate lying between the Tigris and the Euphrates rivers are dumb. Anyone with any intelligence knows that the Garden of Eden is a small piece of land, well-watered, green, an emerald island lying between the baselines in one of those wonderful little parks that dot the Sun Belt. And everyone knows that spring training is not really as much an actual thing as a state of mind. It means that we're tired of winter and there's hope for a spring coming through. And so we project ourselves dreaming about this great state of affairs where every ball player is a phenom, where every club is a winner, where every pitcher can throw harder than Feller, and every hitter is stronger than Ruth. It's really wonderful. And you sit there in the sun and you dream. And we all ought to have a time to dream, because the harsh facts of reality will come soon enough. They come about 3 weeks into spring training, when the pitchers begin to throw curveballs and the hitters begin to take these great young phenoms downtown. And then suddenly we start to change our whole viewpoint. We say, I hope Roland can pull off some larceny that will restore the White Sox to 1983, and that Dallas can steal something from somebody that'll guarantee that the Cubs win that third game. It doesn't always happen, but it makes dreaming worthwhile. You know, I guess of all the things I'd like most in this entire world, other than Mary Frances and the kids, is spring training. And so I really am kind of happy that we got, you know, uninvolved unintentionally, because mm-hmm. that means that I can go there and stay there, and without any feeling of being absent, I can stay and enjoy it. And you know something? Maybe you'll come with.
You can get it if you really. Succeed at last. Mm-hmm. Persecution, you must bear. Win and lose, you've got to get your share. Got your mind set on a dream. You can get it, no harder than seem now. You can get it.